Assalamualaikum and good afternoon. We are from Group 6. We'll be present our case study on frozen banana fritters. Okay, first of all, I want to introduce our group members. My name is Charmin.
My name is Hazwani.
My name is Lijinje.
My name is Putri.
My name is Shazana.
My name is Husni.
Okay, we will proceed to our presentation. Okay, for the introduction, we use many, of course, banana, because we dig banana fritters. It's called Musa IQ Mini, which banana, we know banana is one of the most popular fried snake in Malaysia. We can found along the stall, along the road. Okay, banana may be battered, crumb or both, and when frozen in ready to cook form, they offer a convenient food widely valued by customer. So basically, the frozen product are convenient, ready to cook and easily prepared, especially for busy housewives nowadays. Okay, so the coating freezing technology can be used to produce a new type of healthy frozen banana products made with real banana cuts that providing the taste, texture of the original banana. Okay, actually the consumption of coated banana is an innovative way to increase consumption of fruits in daily diet, especially for children. We know that children nowadays will not take the raw fruit just by this. So when coated with battered, it will gain their appetite to consume fruits. So we know also that banana is rich in dietary fiber, as we are recommended to take food high in dietary fiber to protect against high blood pressure, bowel disease, obesity, stroke, and also diet related cancer. So in this experiment, we develop frozen banana fritters using different formulation, which we use different type of starch. Okay, this is the objective of our case study. The first one is to develop frozen banana fritters made from pisang arbor variety using different ingredients, and also to investigate the effects of different ingredients on the crispiness of developed batter and their acceptance. Okay, proceed to the materials and methods. Okay, I will proceed to the materials and methods. There are three different formulations, which is A, B, and C. For formulation A, there are no added starch. For formulation B, we added tapioca starch. And formulation C, we added potato starch. There are other ingredients, which is wet flour, margarine, salt, sugar, and water. Let's watch the video to see how the banana fritters.
Thank you.
on the figure 1, we can see that the moisture content of frozen banana fritters from formulation C has the highest moisture content compared to the formulation A and B. Okay, for the color of frozen banana fritters, the lightness of banana fritters has the highest lightness on formulation A, while for the redness and yellowness of frozen banana fritters, formulation B has the highest redness and yellowness. Okay, based on the sensory evaluation, formulation B of frozen banana fritters has the highest score in the most of the attributes, which is texture, color, crispiness, flavor, and overall acceptability. Next, I will pass to Jing Jing.
Okay, so I will continue with discussion part, which is first is moisture content. So based on figure 1, banana fritter of formulation B was found to contain the lowest moisture content, followed by the formulation A and then C. So the use of batter has been suggested to reduce the amount of fat absorbed by deep fat fried food by limiting the moisture and the oil transfer during frying. So then according to Kongida et al., there is a strong relationship between oil uptake in deep fried product and the amount of water removal during deep frying. So it can be said that banana fritter made of better formula B, which are rice flour, and then wheat flour, and then tapioca starch, has the highest oil absorption and may cause more oiliness to the taste of the banana fritter. So on the other hand, banana fritter made of better formula C, which are rice flour, wheat flour, and then potato starch, has the highest moisture retention ability and contribute to the juiciness of the banana fritter. And then moisture content in banana fritter can be affected by the water holding capacity of the different flour used. So regular tapioca starch can improve water holding capacity by gelatinizing and increasing viscosity. But compared to potato starch, it can show lower water holding capacity because of this of its lower viscosity and then swelling power. So according to the study of Hermerson and Swissmott, so potato starch is a high swelling starch system that can absorb quite a lot of water, as phosphate group commonly linked to the amylopectin increase the starch hydrophilic nature. His banana fritter made from better formula C has higher moisture content compared to the formulation B, which is the adding with tapioca starch. Okay, so I will pass the next discussion part.
Next, I will proceed with the color. The analysis that we use LAB value, where L stand for lightness, A for redness, and B for yellowness. Color was significantly affected. The color of the banana fritter significantly affected by the flour that we use, because different flour has a different amylopectin and amylose content. Banana fritters using wheat flour for formulation A is a lightest than the formulation B and C. Yantim and Mutia has stated from the study before that increasing concentrations of wheat flour will increase the lightness of the food products. Okay, next is the study before showed that the wheat and tapioca flour have a high L value from the potato starch. For the banana fritters in formulation B, the value of the redness is highest in reddish color. And actually, the other factors that affect the banana fritters is the method of the frying. For example, high temperature and frying time will resulting to the darker color of the banana fritters. Next is sensory evaluations of banana fritters that we use hedonic scale. The banana fritters with tapioca starch in formulation B get the highest score, followed by potato starch in formulation C and formulation in A respectively. The banana fritters with the weak flour information A get the lowest acceptability and preferred with the among the panelists because of the harder texture. This is why the formulation B get a crispiness texture. First is small granule size and amylose contained in the tapioca starch, then lead to the lower swelling power solubility and amylose leaching, low trapping of water in starch, smaller size of air cell formed during frying, so that like what we present before, the moisture content of the banana fritters using a formulation B is low, then will resulting in a crispiness texture. Having high amylose content can be used in food formulation to obtain product with the desirable crunchy or crispiness texture. And studied before state that amylose function is to strengthen the dough, which is then improve the forming and cutting properties of dough to the protein snacks food with a crunchy texture. That's all from the discussion, and we proceed to the conclusion.
So I would like to go to you, Mufad, which is the conclusion, which is conclude our case study. So as a conclusion, different ingredients used in a batter making affect the crispiness and the sensory properties of the banana fritters. And secondly, banana fritters of formulation B with addition of tapioca starch was the most preferred and get higher acceptability than formulation A and C in terms of sensory evaluation. I think that's all from our group. Thank you very much.